Pat Farbaugh with 10th year head coach Chris Valerio. 10 years. The Flash, his team, will open the 2019 season on Saturday at 12:30 at Lehigh University. It is on the Patriot League Network, fans, so you can catch the web stream there. CV, 10 years. Does it seem to go by as quick for you as it seems to have gone from my vantage point?
Yeah, time definitely does fly, doesn't it? Yeah, I was probably about 60 pounds heavier then, and you know, I think I shrunk 2 inches. But it's been a ride. It's been a journey. It's been something that we're very proud of. You know, it's something special that we're trying to build here at St. Francis, and you know, hopefully we can we have the opportunity to stay here and see this thing through.
Let's talk about this 19th season. It's the 50th. Anniversary of the modern era of Red Flash football, and Chris and I will talk about that throughout the season. But let's talk about this first opponent, Lehigh University. Played them last year, lost by 2 in the season opener. It's a Patriot League team. It'll be a good first test, I would think, for your squad. Follow that up with James Madison. So some real good tests right off the bat for your team this year.
Yeah, we're looking forward to it. I mean, Lehigh's they're a great team. You know, they got a new coordinator, new defensive coordinator, new head coach. So I'm sure they're going to have some different wrinkles in there. But we know who they are. That, you know, they're a fundamentally sound program. They fly around the ball. They play with a lot of excitement. They have a lot of pride in who they are. You know, they're building a tradition over there. And it's going to be a hard hitting game. And we're looking forward to it. I think our guys are looking forward to a different venue. I think they're tired of hitting each other at this point. And early in camp, you know, we just ended camp, but you know, it's going to be exciting, and they're a great football team. So you're right, this is going to be a great challenge for us.
Talk a little bit about camp as we obviously camp is closed, season or the semester has started here at St. Francis. Were you pleased overall? Again, you're talking about a lot of guys, and you're talking about some coaches in new positions as well, so some learning on that side as well. Collectively, were you pleased as a head coach with the overall effort and performance through camp?
I thought we came out with great effort every day. I thought overall our effort was great. I think we, you know, developed some depth at certain positions, which is what we were looking for, and I think we found some leaders. And you know, if you can accomplish those goals in camp, you know, that's a good thing. So we just got to keep developing. We have to keep improving each week, and we have to keep holding each other accountable and just doing the small things. Obviously, everyone knows how to do the big things. It's the small things that are going to help you, you know, get them little mini victories here and there that, you know, you need to get the overall big victory.
4-7 last year, fans, 2-4 in the Northeast Conference. That record is deceiving. 6 of those 7 losses were by 8 points or less, including that Lehigh opener a season ago, a loss by 2 points that came down to the buzzer. 1-score losses to Richmond and Albany, 2 very good teams. Chris, you talk about culture a lot, the 2016 title. Now we're entering the third season since the team lifted the trophy over their heads. Again, those close losses last year, is there something that this year's group can take from that, or do you just clean the slate and forget about what happened last year?
You got to learn. You got to learn from it. And I think the thing that we learned is it's 4 quarters of football, and you have to finish everything you do. And when you look at them games, it came down to 2 or 3 big plays in them games. So you have to finish everything, and you can't relax. And, you know, you have to be able to finish everything you do. We have to be able to extend drives offensively. We have to be able to get off the field defensively. You know, and obviously special teams, you know, you got to be able to sustain. And, you know, we did, you know, for sometimes 3 quarters, 2 quarters, or whatnot, we'd be playing great football, and we'd have them lapses, you know, and 2-minute, 3-minute lapses that turn around and cost us.
Can you tell us a little bit on that ties in with that? The mantra for the team this year is Flash, and you talked a little bit about that at Media Day. Can you expand upon that and how that came to fruition? Whose idea was that, and has it been embraced by the players?
Yeah, you know, something that, you know, you hear a lot of teams talk about, you know, their values. And I said, you know, what is our values? And I came in and we started talking, you know, as a staff, and I said, what's Flash mean? And I asked a few people, what's Flash mean to you? And we just came up with it, you know, family, leadership, accountability, service, and honor. And it was something that we did collectively as a staff. And, you know, if we believe in it as a staff, you know, the guys are going to believe in it. And that's something, that's who we are. And, you know, we preach it. We talk about it all the time. The team has embraced it. And I love the direction we're going in right now.
Had some coaching changes. Marco Pecora moves from defensive coordinator to offensive coordinator. Bishop Neal moves up to defensive coordinator. You also have a couple of new coaches. How has that transition gone? And as a head coach, that's your staff. So you're trying to make your players, put them in places to be successful. How has the staff transition gone?
I think they've embraced the challenge. You know, we brought some from new staff on, and they've embraced our culture and who we want to become. And it's fun. You know, we're having a lot of fun as a staff. We're being very creative as a staff, and you know, the staff meetings have, you know, there's been a lot of help on both sides. So it's been great. It's been a great learning experience for all of us, and you know, I hope we can keep this going.
I know every coach is anxious to get to that next game, and preseason is a grind, and I'm guessing you're really excited for 12:30 Saturday to roll around.
Yes, we are. You know, we want to see who we are. We want all the hard work we put in it. We want to let these guys go out and show what they got, and you know, we just gotta, you know, do what we do best, and that's all we can control, and we'll see what happens at the end of the game.
Chris, good luck on Saturday.
I appreciate it, Pat. Thank you.